Hi, my name is Dr. Kate Calvin. I'm NASA's Chief Scientist and Senior Climate Advisor, and I'm going to answer some of the top questions that we're getting from users like you about climate. This May was the hottest May on record, so we've had now 12 consecutive record-breaking months of heat. That means for the last year, every month has been the hottest of that month on record. So May was the hottest May on record, 2023 was the hottest year on record. We're also seeing other changes in ecosystems all around the world. So we're seeing changes in precipitation patterns. We see more heavy precipitation. In some regions, we see more droughts. We're seeing declines in ice, both Arctic sea ice, as well as changes in the mass of ice sheets. We are seeing increases in sea level that affect coastal communities all around the world. And we're seeing all of these changes. We can observe them through surface measurements, we can see them through satellite-based measurements, and we can see how the Earth is changing over time. So what we mean by that is that May is the hottest May on record. April was the hottest April on record. There is still a seasonal cycle, but what we're saying is that winters are getting hotter than anything we've experienced that we've recorded before. Summers are hotter than what we've recorded before, and so that each individual month is respectively the hottest of that month on record. Not necessarily. So we're seeing an overall trend in warming, but we might still see individual years that are hotter or cooler than the previous, and individual months that are hotter or cooler than the previous month. So we are seeing an overall trend in warming, but that doesn't necessarily mean every single month will be the hottest. El Niño is a natural cycle that affects temperatures and weather around the world. El Niño years tend to be warmer on average than others. La Niña years tend to be cooler on average. But with climate change, what we're seeing is an overall trend in warming. So our La Niña years are also getting warmer, as well as our El Niño years. And so we see an overall trend in warming, but we're still seeing individual years that are warmer or cooler than the previous year because of El Niño and La Niña. Well, we know what's driving the warming on our planet. We know it's driven by increases in greenhouse gases. We also know how to limit warming. So we know that by reducing greenhouse gases, we can reduce the rate of warming. And there are options available today that can help us reduce greenhouse gases. There's also people all around the world that are working to better understand our planet and to develop technologies and understanding that can help us address the changes that are happening where I live. And there's people like you that are learning about this now and can help us in the future.